Every state has its folklore, tall tales and legends. But sometimes there is a darker story, a tale not so much told as whispered.
I never knew anybody that was connected to their land the way Dave was. I mean, he loved that land. It's like he was a part of it, and it was a part of him.
Little tension, Andy.
All right.
Dave was a fine craftsman. Made most of his stuff out of sugar maple and red oak that he grew on his property. Dave and Heather were high school sweethearts, and she was the prettiest girl in Alpena County, and she knew it.
A nice spiral grain.
Ah.
Fine log of wood.
He knows.
Pony dog's all right for you fellas?
Yes, ma'am.
She was an expensive wife, though. I mean, she was always asking Dave for stuff he couldn't really afford, and he would get it for her, you know, no matter how much it set him back.
Lunch is served.
Hey there, sexy.
Do I know you?
No. But I heard you're into lumberjacks.
It's true. I do sort of have a thing for dumb, muscular guys.
I guess it's my lucky day. Is that new?
I should have asked you first, but it was just so beautiful. I can take it back.
Well, I like it. We'll find a way to pay for it.
Nobody was expecting an accident. And I'll never forgive myself for not being there.
Hey, Andy just called. Wow.
You like it?
That is gonna turn a few heads tonight.
Just a few. What about Andy?
Andy called in sick. We were supposed to fell a tree together, and now I'm gonna have to do it by myself, so we may be a little late.
Babe, we're on the fundraising committee. We have to show up on time.
I know. But there's weather coming in tomorrow, and I'm short of lumber. Maybe you could give me a hand?
Now?
It's just a little tree. Well, actually, it's a really big tree, but it won't take long.
Fine.
Love you.
Come on.
Hey, keep the line taut, okay?
Sorry.
It's okay.
You're losing too much blood. I gotta get you free.
David, please, no, no, no!
Heather had this sort of light about her. She just shined. But after she lost that arm, she was like a different person. Everything went dark. I think maybe after she lost that arm, and maybe she didn't really want people seeing anymore. Not being perfect. She felt like if she wasn't the most beautiful girl in Alpena County, Dave wasn't gonna love her anymore. And that couldn't have been further from the truth.
It's hideous. David? Can you really make that?
I think so. I just want you to be happy.
Can you make it out of cold?
Are you serious? We can't afford that.
Do you still love me?
Yes, more than anything.
Please make it out of cold.
Took out a second mortgage. Sold a tractor. Bandsaw.
Thank you.
made of gold?
Yes, it is.
Are you a princess? Where did you get it?
My prince made it for me.
I think it's beautiful. Bye.
Every woman wants to be beautiful. But it was like Heather's whole identity was locked up in it. She wanted to be the most beautiful girl all the time. It was like a drug. And she couldn't get enough of it, and Dave couldn't give her enough of it. Then, of course, winter came. Heather got sick.
The tests have come in that is pulmonary gold disease. As long as your body keeps absorbing the gold through your skin, there's very little I can do. You've got to take off that prosthetic.
No. I can't take off my golden arm. Ever.
Sir?
Whatever she wants. Right here.
I had a dream. A terrible dream. Promise me something.
Anything.
When I die, bury me with my golden arm. Promise.
Yes.
See it.
I will bury you with your golden arm.
After Heather passed, there wasn't much work around here, so Dave had to lay me off. And when that recession hit, nobody was buying handcrafted furniture.
I need it back.
Ah! Thank you.
Lacey and police. They never could figure out what happened. But the good folks here reburied Heather's body with that golden arm just the way she wanted it. And we put Dave's body in there next to her. We simple folk around here. Most folks didn't even get out of high school. And every one of us knows exactly where that certain golden arm is buried. Just waiting for the taking. But ain't nobody here fool enough to dig it up.